Hi, PCA families. This is Mike Green here. Welcome back to the briefing room here at PCA, where we seek to keep you connected to what we just did in the last month and where we're going in the next month. Over 100 new families have joined us since the start of school. We're now in our fourth week, and as you know, our whole theme has been to take flight. And we took off, and we gained altitude, and now we're cruising. And let's talk about what we did in September and where we're going in October. So a big part of the first month of school is obviously new norms and routines, but also is becoming a part of community. With over 100 new families and many of us returning after a year of COVID, plugging your sons and daughters in to things that they really care about and are interested in is a big part of what we've been doing here, as well as you parents and grandparents. So everything from Brookwoods with our upper school students going up to Lake Winnipesaukee, to our sports teams now down at the junior high level, to club formation, all kinds of things, kaleidoscope, plugging you into community, getting you involved in things you'd love to do, but more importantly, meeting some wonderful people, classmates for your sons and daughters, and other parents just like you. Big part of what this last month has been about. As we come back to school, one of the big things that we're trying to do is help you as moms and dads and as grandparents to be able to see what we're doing here at school. And so one of the things we've been trying to do is helping you see that from the kindergartners on the playground and what they're doing, all the way to our upper school students, what they're doing at lunch, what they're doing at their sports events, and everything in between. So reaching our community in the Seacoast is one of our other broad goals. And we found out in early September that you had nominated PCA once again as best in the Seacoast. And so we sure appreciate that. And more importantly, we appreciate all the goodwill and connection that you've given us into these communities of Maine, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts. So thanks a lot. Please be sure to vote when you get the opportunity. And we sure always appreciate the good word to your friends and neighbors. When we turn our sights to the athletic fields and the courts and cross-country courses, our teams have done incredibly well, everything from the junior high all the way up to the varsity level. I want to highlight two outstanding athletic performances. Ella Walsh, our sophomore goalkeeper for our varsity women's soccer team, had 20 saves in a valiant effort against Newmarket. And even at a higher level, Joey Skubish, captain of our women's volleyball team, was just named AVCA Player of the Week for the week of 6 to 10 September. Varsity volleyball currently holds a 4-2 record. And our fine arts program also got off to a great start. You saw the video of our junior high and lower school students picking up their instruments for the first time this year. And I see them every day, and I know you see them every day, bringing their instruments into campus as they play individually, ensembles, and symphony and orchestra. So it's been a full month here at PCA as we formed community, got our programs going, got academics settled in, took our NEWAs. Let's look forward to October. So one of the goals on the briefing room is to give you a look into what's happening in October. The first week of October is homecoming week right here on campus. Schedules have started to go out already, what to wear, what we're going to be doing. But really, again, the whole goal here is the culmination of forming community. Most of it is with our students right here, culminating especially for our junior high and high school students on Friday, going all the way into Saturday of homecoming week, culminating with our Dig Pink volleyball game. You can see all the different events that we have. We want you, our families, to come back. And if you have alumni, we certainly love to see them back on Saturday as we dedicate the alumni orchard in between games and the Dig Pink volleyball tournament. So week one of October, homecoming week. A couple of big things that are happening on that short week are our auditions for all of our programs, our winter programs, which go all the way from junior high all the way through upper grades, will be happening, as well as auditions for our spring musicals, so we can get plenty of time for those amazing costumes that require building and putting together and assembling, and also giving plenty of time for our musicians to tune up, as well as our vocalists to learn their songs. So know that tryouts are coming up, starting at the fourth grade all the way up in the middle week of October. So academically, in the middle of October, a couple things are happening. Our 10th and 11th graders are taking their PSAT. It's right here on campus as part of the program that they do. For the 11th graders, this is your PSAT of record for your National Merit Scholar qualifications. Our seniors will be taking their SAT right here on campus at the end of October. So you can see that we've moved from NEWAs at the lower school in 9th and 10th grade and focus in September now to PSAT and SAT. Again, our consistent battery of academic assessment here to help your children maximize their potential as they leave campus. As we head into our third week of October, our sports teams are getting ready to make their final push for the playoffs. If you don't know, PCA has a long history for being a relatively small school, but always have very competitive teams and athletes as we head into the postseason, and this year is no different. So as you look to the third week of October, we encourage you from the junior high to the high school level, look for those home games, even the away games, and come cheer on our athletes. Go Eagles. As we wrap up the fourth week of October, the end of October, believe it or not, we're closing out on quarter one of our 21-22 school year. That Friday is a half day. It's the last day of the quarter. It is also Grandparents' Day. We're welcoming and ask you to invite our grandparents, your grandparents, to come to school. We have programs set up at the lower school from PCAP all the way up to eighth grade to invite them in and have them participate. But we also have programs at the upper school. And for grandparents who have kids in both schools, we've got it all scheduled out to take care of them. We hope to see grandparents, your grandparents, kids, right here on campus, last day of the quarter, 29th of October. So as we close out the briefing room for this month, we want to encourage you to continue to plug into community. The biggest event for us is homecoming week. So as your sons or daughters like want to dress up in a crazy way, know we approve of that for this week in particular. Just to go with it, enjoy it with them. And then when you look to the weekend on Friday and Saturday, we encourage you to come on campus yourselves. Bring your kids, come visit a varsity soccer game or the cross-country meet. And just a hint, we're going to have a special guest here on campus that we think all kids of all ages, from 1 to 99, will enjoy seeing and meeting right here on campus. Again, more to follow, a bit of a surprise. Think the guest will be here Friday, certainly be here Saturday of homecoming week. Again, we look forward to seeing you on campus. God bless you. Go Eagles. PCA community, I just want to take a few minutes to introduce you to three of our sports athletic leaders, team captains in some cases here on our fall sports teams. So Dylan Thang, Joey Skubish, Alula Womberg, men's soccer, volleyball, women's volleyball, and women's soccer varsity. And so I just want to take a few minutes and sort of go down this way. We'll kick it around a little bit. Sure. So Dylan, give me a highlight so far for men's soccer.
Yeah, so highlight, our record right now is 4-3. We've been doing pretty well as a team, communicating and all that fun stuff.
Okay. Yeah, our record right now is 3-1, and we have a lot of new players in our pretty hefty JV team, so our future is looking very bright right now.
Yeah, it's great, and we've got some new coaches as well. We're really excited.
Yes, Coach Sophia, we're so happy.
Lula, how about you guys?
So we're doing super great so far. We've only lost one game out of all of them. Pretty handily beat all of them. Our team's coming together so well, even as like so many new freshmen. So
how are the health dynamics affected the team for you guys? Has it had any impact? And if so, how have you navigated it? So Joey, Lula first.
I can start. We actually last practice, we had a few players out because of, you get a stuffy nose now and unfortunately you can't come because of all the COVID protocols. And so it's been a bit of an issue, but we've kind of lucked out for games. It seems everyone's back healthy. I know we lost Maggie, one of our seniors, for one game, but we've been pretty lucky so far.
Okay.
So beginning of the season, we kind of got hit pretty hard. I think we had a bunch of people out for a lot of games, so we were struggling a little bit. And now everyone's pretty much back. A few more out, but
yeah, it's great.
Getting back.
Yeah, for sure. We were also hit hard at the beginning of the season. Our main striker, Jason Stockbauer, and he was out for a long time. He's our top striker, one of the best on our team. And so not having him was definitely a struggle for us, but we worked around it and got through.
Yeah, I mean, that's a part of, I think, for all of it, right, is we all have to work around it, whether it's injuries, sickness, or whatever. So it sounds like you guys have done, that's been a key part. So you talk about how well you did, but now, obviously, it's not been a clean slate, it's been a challenge. So tell us a little bit about your team. You mentioned, Joey, your younger members of your team. I don't know, Lula, if you've got any young players. I know, because I've watched you guys a little bit, as well, as that you got some young players. Just tell us who you're seeing coming up and any highlights, either players or just sort of the attitude and heart of the young players. So, Lily, you want to go first?
Yeah, so our team is fairly like young. We have a lot of new people to soccer even. So that's been a challenge, but I've really seen them step up and practice so hard to become better. And freshmen, like my sister Avery and Tatum Smith, have both like stepped up. They're pretty much starting, doing amazing.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah, we have two freshmen who are playing on varsity, Macy Andrus and Madeline, and they've both been crushing it, you know, just so, showing so much spirit at practice is great. They're both very hard workers. And Michaela, who's a senior, but she's never played volleyball before, and she joined us the season. She's starting, and she's doing great.
Really contributing.
Yes.
How about you, Dylan?
Yeah, so also our team has a lot of young players. Our goalie is actually a freshman. He's doing so well. His name's Jaden. And, man, like, he saved a bunch of our games. And it was – young guys are doing well. So
yeah. Eagle community, you may have seen. If you didn't, so Joey Skubish was just announced as the ABCA Player of the Week last week. It's the fourth, only the fourth PCA player in all of the last 20 years to receive that recognition. Yeah. Joey, what are you thinking? How are you feeling?
It was very exciting when I got that text from Coach Kevin. Lindsay got it last year, and she's my best friend of all time. And so to be able to share that experience with her was really cool. And I could not have done it without the help of my team. I mean, probably the main reason was the amount of kills that I got. And without Maddie setting me up and without our team passing, it's impossible. And so I'm very grateful for them and to have such a great coach who believes in us.
Yeah, that's great. Thanks so much. Mm-hmm. So Lula, your team last year, for the first time in school history, went to the state semifinals. Farthest we've ever gone. It's led by Elise Gillis and some other seniors, Julie Young and others. They're gone, right? So how have you all filled that leadership void, and you in particular have really stepped up?
It was really hard in the beginning to have people step up, but I've seen so many different people step up and fill those roles. Because Jewel was defense, Elise was offense, so just kind of filling those spots was difficult, but we've definitely stepped up and filled them and been able to execute and work together.
Do you ever hear from any of them at all? I know Jewel, you know, they're out playing, they're reaching back and encouraging you guys. That's awesome. So Dylan, I think one of the big news items for us is Coach Chase. Step back, great coach for many years, and then we have Mr. Abood, who's one of our Bible teachers, head of our Bible department, is now coaching. Just tell us about Mr. Abood as a coach and just how the team has responded.
Yeah, so Coach Abood, Mr. Abood, like he just said, stepped up because Coach Chase left, and we had a few good years with Coach Chase. But Mr. Abood, Coach Abood came up and filled right in for Coach Adam, and been very, very hard, on the team. But that's a good thing. You want to be hard on your team, and you know, just that encouragement and that Christ-like attitude in Coach has definitely impacted our team.
That's great. Who are you looking forward to playing? Not just next, but upcoming in the year. And what are you looking towards playoffs? How do you think that's going to play out?
Okay, so I'll answer this one. So we're looking forward to Sunapee.
Okay.
Because they're a very good northern team. We played them. I don't think we played them, but they're very good. And so I want to see that challenge. I want to challenge our young guys to get out there. And,
So Sunapee.
Okay.
Yeah, Farmington's our big one. We lost them in playoffs last year, 5 sets. And I think we lost by a total of 3 points overall the whole match.
Have we played them yet?
No, not yet this year. It's our homecoming match, actually.
All
so
right.
October 8th.
Shout out for homecoming.
Yeah, big game. And so we're probably around equal playing ground, at least we were last year. And so it made it a really good match to be in, but it's definitely a challenge, and so I'm excited for that.
So most recently, Concord Christian, that's who we're playing on Friday. They're equal playing field with us, so.
Yeah. Good team.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll be fun. So that's coming up this Friday?
Yeah.
All right. So you heard a little bit about what's coming up, some other great teams in our area, our athletes rising to the occasion. We're so proud of you. Look forward to what God is doing in and through you as leaders, your fellow captains, but also your youngest, and we got a great JV program coming up through through volleyball as well. So let's go Eagles. See you on the court, see you on campus.